Hilsert and Associates proudly present Superstars of Gymnastics. Starring the winner of 9 Olympic medals, 5 of them gold, gymnastics' first perfect 10, Nadia Comaneci. The only American gymnast to win gold medals at every level of national and international competition, 2-time Olympic champion, Bart Conner. This young lady has 3 Olympic gold medals and 5 world championship gold medals, Svetlana Boginskaya. This couple has been 5-time world champions in sports acrobatics, Evgeny Marchenko and Natasha Redkova. World champion Valentin Mugilny. Herself a 3-time world champion, this is Valentin's wife, Olga Bicharova Mugilny. The winner of 2 Olympic gold medals and 2 world championship gold medals, and one of the nicest guys in gymnastics, this is Valery Liukin. Three-time world champion, the United States' own Kim Zemesko. The Romanian team represented by the top 3 members of that team. This is Nadia Hatagan, Gina Gogian, Lavinia Milosevic, and their coach, Octavian Belu. The next young lady is the present junior national champion on her way, we know, to Atlanta in 96 with her coach, the most famous coach in the world, Bella Caroli and Dominique Mucciano. And I'd like to introduce a young man who won 6 Olympic gold medals in 1992, and he's on his way to 1996. This is Vitali Sherba.
USA Network presents Superstars of Gymnastics. From Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, the world's best gymnast in a gymnastics spectacular.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Spectrum in Philadelphia. I'm Michael Barkan, and USA has a special night of gymnastics on tap for you, the Superstars of Gymnastics, which really is a first-of-a-kind event. It combines gymnastics with a flair and also the hardcore elements of the sport. Speaking of flair, we'll bring in my partners for this evening. First, the man who invented the Thomas flair, Kurt Thomas, former Olympian, 3-time world champion, and Wendy Hilliard, former rhythmic gymnastics champ, president of the Women's Sports Foundation. We'll start with Kurt. Talk to me about the men on the docket tonight.
Well, Michael, you talk about the superstars of men's gymnastics. We've got them here. 1984 Olympic gold medalist Bart Conner, most decorated U.S. gymnast ever. We've also got Vitali Sherbo, 6-time Olympic gold medalist. He's shooting for 96, won in 92. And we've got Valery Liukin. He's the first man ever to perform a triple back on the floor, so he should be fun to watch.
Wendy, we mentioned flavor. What does that mean with regard to this event?
Well, this is really performance gymnastics, so the emphasis is going to be on the music, the choreography, and the themes to the routine. But we've got great women gymnasts, because Nadia Comaneci is here. But also joining Nadia, we have Svetlana Boginskaya, who is a world champion and Olympic champion. And then we have Kim Zemesko, who's the 1991 all-around world champion. Now, both Svetlana and Kim are going out for the 1996 Olympics, but they're going to have to look out for 13-year-old Dominique Mucciano.
All right, flips, tumbles, and jumps, no matter how you slice it, it means excitement on USA tonight.
some greased lightning when Superstars returns in a moment.
USA Network.
To make a racket. And there's only one place where you can see over 80 hours of live exclusive coverage of
America's Grand Slam.
See Sampras, Agassi, Chang, and Courier take on the world as Graf and Sanchez Vaccaro try to fight off the charge of rising stars like America's Lindsay Davenport. It's heart in the middle of the nation.
The U.S. and all the USA.
August the 8th through September 10th.
Bart Conner and Nadia Comaneci rock and roll the crowd to their medley from the Broadway musical Grease. This is something interesting. We have not seen this in gymnastics before.
Well, what's really important is adding dancers, professional dancers, that is. It's an important component to the theatricality of the event.
Here's our beauty school dropout, Pauletta Huntescu, otherwise known as Paul Hunt.
The finest gymnastics clown in the world, we call him. A lot of things people don't know about this guy. He's back in the 70s, he won floor exercise, national championships.
Is he the only gymnastics clown in the world?
He's the only good one. A lot of people try, but he's the best.
On your smile. Graduation day for you, beauty school dropout, Mr. Midterm.
Kurt, hopefully this is one guy who doesn't take his job home with him.
Well, you know, he's got a gym school, and the way he got started in this is he was helping a girl on the balance beam with a balance beam skill, and he actually did it better than she did, a backflip on the beam. And then he started performing and did an exhibition once, and now he goes all over the world with his act.
So originally, he developed it as a teaching technique.
Yeah, just sort of helping one of his girls out in the gym.
Oh, there goes the wig. Make sure that skirt's in place.
Now here comes one move that most of the guys don't usually do.
Beauty school dropout. Hanging around the corner store.
drop out. It's about time you knew the score. Well, they couldn't teach you anything. You think you're such a lucker, but no customer would go to you.
You know, the whole thing might work if he shaved his back. Just a thought.
Baby, don't sweat it. You're not cut out to hold the job. Better forget it.
He makes the mistakes. The messing up seems so easy.
Well, kids, don't try that one at home, but he's a master in pratfalls, you'll see throughout the show.
Paulette's a Hunt-askew. Paul Hunt. We'll see him later. Right now, we're going to twist just a little bit with Dominique Moceanu. 13 years old, from Houston, Texas, she is the youngest to ever make a United States national team.
And she's really the future for USA Gymnastics. She's going to give the other gymnasts a good run for her money as she goes for the 96 Olympics. Second pass. Whoa, 2.5 twist.
Dominique is the reigning junior national champion, and this year is her first year as a senior.
Last pass, double back, not a bad landing.
And she finishes with a twist, Dominique Moceanu. This next number has some hidden meaning, as we'll explain. Nadia Comaneci and Chapel of Love. That rock. See, Nadia is getting married, probably a year from now, to Bart Connor.
That's why she's smiling at the opening of that routine. A lot of fun. You know, you can't have a dancey show without a kick line.
She's kept in terrific shape. I mean, over the years, she's done some exhibitions. She's had some trouble with her knee, but she's really kept in great shape.
She looks like she's having fun out there.
She really is. They're having a great time at this kind of show. You get to express yourself. It's not just gymnastics. And there she got to kiss her groom on national television. She's having a good time.
Not bad. Nadia and Bart. Chapel of Love. Here's Bart's take on tonight's premier event.
You know, I've always been really sort of disappointed in our sport in that it's a wonderful sport in competition on TV. People love to watch it. But the disappointing thing for the athletes is when they're finished competing, there's basically nowhere to go with these talents. And that's a shame. Because in any other business, whether you're an accountant or whether you're a writer or a TV producer, there is a market for what you do, right? In gymnastics, you learn all these wonderful things and it has no value. Maybe you can coach, that's about it. So I've always felt that why don't we find out a way where we can extend the careers of these athletes, allow them to enjoy gymnastics, because most of them, when they're done competing, they've been through that intense, uptight, competitive atmosphere. They still love to do gymnastics, but there's no place to showcase it. And now finally we have someplace.
with Bart and Nadia's help. And now it's Bart Connor's turn.
It's automatic.
And you can tell Bart likes this. He likes what he's doing here. He is a performer. He's not just a gymnast anymore. And when you go through years and years of exhibitions and performing around the country and around the world, this is what happens. You become a performer.
Something you don't see often is Bart Connor on a balance beam. He has said that he wants to be considered the Scott Hamilton of gymnastics. Is he on the right track?
Well, he really is, because the thing that you have to do besides gymnastics is you have to dance a little bit. And we'll see Bart dancing a lot. Kurt can tell you, male gymnasts generally don't like dancing. But that's what makes a changeover so important, and he's getting out there and jamming with the dancers.
Over to the P-bars. I'll tell you, when it comes to energy level, you don't find many who have more of it than Bart Connor.
And that what really helps sell this show is high energy and a lot of fun.
Three-time Olympian, 37 years old.
And I tell you, it's not easy jumping from one piece of apparatus to the other. You know, he just worked on the parallel bars. He ran over, jumped on top of the horse, and now he's doing flares. It takes it out of you.
Grease Lightning, John Travolta, eat your heart out. Now our final number from Grease, Born a Hand Jive.
A good addition having the dancers involved in a show like this. I mean, you can see the expression on their faces. That's what they do. This is their livelihood, and you can tell they just love it.
They don't just dance.
No.
There's some gymnastics involved, even from the dancers.
Well, what's nice, Tony Coppola, who is the choreographer here, is mainly a dance choreographer out of L.A., but he's done a great job in combining the gymnastics and the dance for this show.
This young lady coming through is only a four-time national champ. Whoa, Kim's Meskel.
And you see why, with three whip backs through to a nice high layout, she's in really good shape.
She likes to hand jive too.
How low can you go? How low can you go? How low can you go?
That's a specially made guitar, as you'll see.
And turns it into a little floor pommel horse.
So fun is also, of course, the use of props. You got a car, a guitar, and great costumes.
And if anyone could make this type of gymnastics event a success on an ongoing basis, it's folks like Kim Zemeskal and Bart Conner and Nadia Comaneci, as their Greece number comes to a close. And this is really just the beginning on USA. We've got so much more gymnastics action and exhibition for you. What do we call this move, Wendy?
That's three whipbacks into a layout, kickout layout.
We're going to see more of that when we return from Philadelphia.
From Boston.
Welcome back. We saw some of the theatrics a moment ago, and now perhaps some of the more traditional aspects of gymnastics while still combining some of the theatrics.
Valentin Mogilny. He's an old prospector looking for his horse.
Well, when he finds his horse, you're going to see some spectacular gymnastics, that's for sure. He's probably the best gymnast in the world on the pommel horse, even to this day.
I just heard a horse. And he just happened to have his tights.
Well, watch this. Watch how he swings. Starts out with loops on the ends. Look at the body extension. And he makes it look so easy. Works from the pommel down to the horse, back to the horse, in between the pommels. I can't tell you how difficult that is. And look at his flare work.
How much of this is strength and how much is balance?
Well, the balance factor is very important. It's very easy to fall off either forward or backward. And, you know, when you're performing up and down the way he is, it's real easy to fall off. So that's what I mean by him making it look so easy.
Valentin thanking his horse. And isn't it just like Valentin to thank his horse when he does all the work? Valentin Mogilny. Kurt?
Well, watch this slow motion look at his dismount. His hips are way above the horse. His flare work is very extended, meaning he gets his hips out and his legs are real straddled. And then he pushes up through the handstand effortlessly. That's why he's one of the best in the world, if not the best.
Right now, Gina Gojin. From Romania, 7 world and Olympic medals here on the floor exercise.
And opening with the double layout shows you why. In women's floor exercise, each routine lasts between a minute and a minute 30. And you have to combine wonderful moves like that, which they call a popa, which is dance and gymnastics.
One thing I'm impressed with is Wendy, she mounted with a double layout. They're not really holding back in the difficulty area, are they?
No, I think they really want to improve their competitive routines. And when you come to an exhibition, you can always try some new elements.
You feel a little less tight, perhaps, at an exhibition?
Right, you have a little bit less to lose if you make a mistake. Whoa, of course, that 2.5 twist was a mistake. You'll see in the women's floor exercise, you're doing a lot more front tumbling and twisting because the rules have changed a little bit, so it makes the routines have much more variety.
Gina's 17 years old, 4 feet, 8 inches tall, 79 pounds.
And finishes with a nice double back.
Gina Elena Gojin from Chimpuri, Romania.
Well, here you see you've got a gain of speed. Transfers the weight back. And then she's lifting for a double back, just grabbing it in the tuck position.
and a very solid landing.
Up next, Vitaly Sherbo, 23 years old from Minsk. He is a stud. 22 world and Olympic medals over the past 4 years. Six of them golds, one at the 92 games in Barcelona.
One of them gold on the parallel bars. He's nursing a little bit of a shoulder injury and also a wrist injury right now, but I don't think you'll be able to detect it in this routine.
What are the blue guard straps that he has on his...
For that skill right there, a pike double front on the parallel bars. It makes it a little easier on the upper arms. There's his Healy twirls to a hop pirouette to an immediate glide kip. We talked about how effortlessly McGillney worked the pommel horse. Look at this guy swing on the parallel bars. There's his pike double back. Beautiful routine.
Vitaly Sherbo, 23 years old from Minsk.
Olympic gold medalist Vitaly Sherbo.
And now to the unevens. And Dominique Moceanu and her coach, Bella Caroli.
You know, Michael, Dominique may be one of the reasons Bella's back in coaching. He retired after 92, but she is quite a talent and really can make an impact, possibly the 96 Olympics.
We've drawn some comparisons to figure skating here tonight, and the music really seems to go nicely with the routines.
Well, for this routine, I'm sure they just added the music because she's doing her competitive routine, and you can see with moves like this, she's preparing for her release. Here we have a ginger, and then she goes right back to the low bar, which is one of the requirements. You see, she's a little small, so it's harder for her to transfer between the two, but it makes it easier for giants like that and a double layout flyaway.
Wow. 13-year-old Dominique Moceanu.
Here's her dismount. Watch this. There are two flips in the laid out position and a pretty good landing. One step back.
Time once again for a little humor. It says Paul Hunt, but he may be going by Huntanova, Pauletta Huntanova or Huntescue on the balance beam.
And you know, Paul has two daughters who are also gymnasts, so I'm sure he probably has to tell his kids, now, honey, I'm going to wear this to work today.
Don't be alarmed. We mentioned before how easy he makes it seem. How difficult is it to practice this type of routine and to perform a routine that underscores mistakes?
Well, you'll see that, as you said, your gymnastics is very, very difficult. And what is funny is that he's doing all these elements so well. But it takes a lot of practice, but Paul is a pro.
Gives new meaning to the words cracking a smile, I think.
You know, he's extremely strong, too. It's obvious his body's physically in great shape. But look at this, a split underneath the beam. That's not easy to do.
He is a crowd favorite here in Philadelphia.
Let's not forget the chewing gum. It's all what you're not supposed to do when you do gymnastics.
That's it, Paul. Make sure the skirt's down. There we go. Smile.
Which everybody does when they watch Paul Hunt.
As Kurt mentioned before, Big Ten champ on the floor X once upon a time, and national champ on the floor X. I don't think he ever did the beam though, did he?
And no one gets up on the beam quite like Paul can do it.
Thank you. also known as Paul Hunt. And when we return from Philadelphia, Svetlana Boganskaya will be strutting her stuff on the beam. That's coming up next when Superstars of Gymnastics continues.
Please have one.
For something new, this is mixed pairs, Valentin and Olga Mogilny. They hail from Paris, France. Valentin's a six-time Olympic and world gold medalist. Six golds, one silver, and he is coached by his wife.
That's got to be pretty interesting, to be coached by your wife. I think she watches him more from a technical standpoint.
Is that fairly uncommon in this sport for a woman to coach a man?
Very uncommon, especially at this level.
But granted, Olga is a world champion herself, so she has some credibility there.
1 World champions, but probably the most successful gymnast to never grace an Olympic team.
He was an alternate, but never really on the team.
This is a routine they're doing from Carmen.
And really, when you say mixed pairs for floor exercise, she's going to do most of the dancing elements, and he'll do most of the tumbling elements. Now, here's a nice combination. She's leaping, and he's doing whip backs through a full twist.
Can you see this working in competition?
Definitely, because you have different athletes that may tumble very well and others that dance well. You can really pick up on both of these qualities in the floor exercise event.
Have either of you ever done routines with members of the opposite sex?
I did a long time ago in a touring show that we did around the United States, and it's not easy. I mean, you are concentrating on what you're doing and not the other performer, but you also have to work together. It's beautiful flare work done on the floor there.
Now, it seems to me that they would try perhaps some of what you see in figure skating, the same routine, the same moves at the same time. But I guess they're still working that out.
Still working on it. I think for now it definitely has its place in the performance side of gymnastics.
It's a little different in that you don't see the synchronized tumbling. You don't see any lifts done, but there's a nice double back.
Nice work by the Mogilnys, Valentin and Olga. Let's take a look at some of his flare work, Kurt.
Well, in slow motion here, you can see how he gets his hips up real high. Good extension. Look at the split in his legs, and he's doing quarter turns. We call those spindling turns. Very nicely done.
On the balance beam, it's Svetlana Boganskaya, the Belarusian Swan. Originally from Minsk, she now resides in Houston, Texas. She's 22 years old. She's been training here for about a year. How does she find adjusting to the United States?
When I came first time, it was like a year ago. It was kind of hard because I couldn't speak any English. I was living with American family, with people who helped me a lot, who used to teach me just everything, you know. What should I do here? How should I like represent myself? How should I talk to people? I should smile all the time, because it's America. So, and now everybody asking, oh, whenever I used to see you smile when you was little, I said, well, I'm changing. So, I do like it to live here.
Up on the balance beam, her goal is the 96 Olympic Games. Would be her third Olympics.
Michael, Wendy and I have toured with her, and she loves to dance. Every chance she can, she dances, and she kind of dancing into the darkness there, but she'll be appearing on the beam in just a second here.
How much of a problem is this for a mount?
Well, you go from your eyes being adjusted to darkness to bright lights. It's kind of difficult, but she handled that front tuck really well.
Fourteen Olympic and world champion medals. 8 golds, 4 silvers, and 2 bronze.
And 2 nice back layouts there. One thing, Svetlana really has her own style. She's very sensuous in her movement, and she's very good with the music.
She quit the sport after the Seoul Olympics when her coach and her surrogate mother, Lyubov Miraminova, hung herself, and that devastated Svetlana. But she finally returned to the gym in 1989 and went on to win the overall world title.
Well, it's been a tough life, but I think she's really channeled that into her gymnastics, and she has a lot of passion in her work.
There's no question she loves to perform. That's why she's still out there.
Her favorite events, right here, and the Florex. And we'll show you that upcoming.
Here she's setting for her dismount. Concentrating, and a nice double back. Hey, but we're not finished yet.
Svetlana Boganskaya, 22 years old, the Belarusian swan. Here's the mount out of the darkness.
Yeah, this is what they call a blind landing. Anytime you travel front, it's really hard to land, but she was right on, right lined up. And here you have another front on the beam. See how solid she is? She's such a performer.
Over to the floor where Valery Liukin is standing by. He's from Kazakhstan, Alma-Ata, Kazakhstan.
As you can see there, the first gymnast ever to complete a triple back on the floor exercise, competed that internationally. This guy can tumble. I tell you, he's a performer.
Kurt, it's said that he's known as a trickster rather than a classically trained gymnast. What does that mean?
Well, you'll see in a minute here. He'll start his first pass. He does a full in, double back with a full twist really high. He used to do a lot of real difficult skills from the high bar, difficult skills on the floor, obviously with the triple back. But he just really goes for it. He's, watch this. Nice, easy running. Pulls a full in back out with a pair of jeans on and some suspenders. There's a side. Usually does a one and three where he rolls out of that. Now we saw Mogilny do the flare work. Look at this flare work. Right up to the handstand and back down into flares. Lost a suspender.
No big deal. They're gone.
Problem is he's not in very good shape. Can't you tell?
It's terrible. His last major meet, the 91 Worlds, he won a bronze in the all-around. He tried a comeback at the 93 Worlds, and he tried the triple back somersault you spoke of, and some said if he had not gone for it, he would have medaled. Valery Liukin from Kazakhstan. Over to Gina Gosian on the unevens. To Elton John.
Now that's quite a move. All of the female gymnasts are going to be doing more giant work as she's performing here with some pirouettes and a lot of releases. It's a change in the uneven bar work, but the Romanians are some of the best in the world.
The spirit born of earth and water.
We have another release, reverse heck. Now she's preparing for her dismount. Another double layout.
Coach Octavian Belu, there to spot her. Gina Gosian from Romania. Now to her teammate on the beam, Lavinia Milosevic.
Lavinia is a great gymnast. You can see the quality of her work. She flows from each element to the next element, and that's really the quality of very good training. Side summy on the beam. Remember, the beam is only 4 inches wide, so anytime you travel sideways, it's that much more difficult.
Lavinia, 18 years old. She's 5'1".
Seasoned veteran next to her teammates.
At Barcelona for Lavinia. Gold in the Florex. Gold in the vault, silver in the team, and a bronze in the all-around.
And you know, Michael, I think what she's waiting for is to get the Olympic gold all-around medal. She's always come in either second or third, and I think she wants to come back in 96 and take that all-around gold.
Milos, to her friends, she's considered Romania's top gymnast since her bronze in 92.
Now you can see the level changes that are required during the beam. You have to, of course, tumble over the beam, but you also must be in a low position on the beam.
When you watch the Romanians, and it was said of Nadia when she competed, they don't seem to smile much.
Well, hey, you gotta concentrate.
Lavinia Milosevic. Another look at Gina Gojian.
Now watch this move. It's called the Maraniche. It is so difficult, very few guys even do it.
And once again, Lavinia Milosevic.
Now this is her acro series. She starts with a back handspring, and then she goes to a layout, and then another back handspring right to the end of the beam.
Still much more to come from the Spectrum when we come back. A look at some street scenes. That's next when Superstars of Gymnastics continues. Philadelphia at the Spectrum, Superstars of Gymnastics, and we truly have seen some superstars tonight, Wendy. What are we going to see coming up?
Well, next we're going to have the street scenes, and you're going to see some hip-hop, which is the funkiest dancing in the 90s, but then also there's some theme gymnastics, scenes that you'd see if you were walking down the streets, but the gymnasts are doing it to some really cool music. But then you're also going to see a little rhythmic gymnastics and some more sports acrobatics.
All right, behind the scenes, Kurt, the gym is talking about gymnastics catching up with figure skating, and it would seem events like this would really do that.
Well, we are on our way. With the addition of the dancers, all the music, the choreography, the great lighting effects, we are now putting on a show with gymnastics, which has been needed for a long time. We're on our way to compete with those figure skaters.
All right, and right now it's time for some street scenes. Hot legs, Diane Durham, and the LA dancers.
You know, Diane was a national champion back in 1983, and she really just missed the 84 team. But as you can see, she's been doing a lot of performing.
Yeah, it was kind of unfortunate. She sprained her ankle, and they wouldn't let her through to the Olympic trials because she didn't finish. And so they couldn't petition her onto the team, so it was unfortunate.
It was really tragic, but she still does great gymnastics.
So would you say she is now a dancer who does gymnastics or a gymnast who dances?
No, definitely a gymnast who dances. That's the thing about all of these dancers that you see here. Many of them were gymnasts before and they took a lot of dance training, but you see Diane,
wow,
as high as she tumbles, she's a gymnast at heart. Michael, one thing to get great legs, dance and gymnastics will do it for you. The exercise is wonderful.
They are some pretty spectacular legs.
It's all those high kicks.
Oh, and who is stealing the show here? It's Pauletta Hunteskew.
Talk about hot legs.
Talk about hairy legs.
Yeah, he needs a shave. Yeah, we don't want him in our routine. Don't cry. Some hot legs with Diane Durham. and the LA Dancers. And now it's time for Dragnet.
I work here.
Marchenko and Redkova. Yevgeny Marchenko and Natasha Redkova. Sport acrobatics chance five times over.
They dominated sports acrobatics for 5 years. No one was even close to them. And you'll see why right here. Very precise sport. And this guy can move for a big guy. He's 6'4".
And she's 5'2". That's quite a difference. In fact, if you'd like it to figure skating, more along the lines of Gordieva and Grinkov with the disparity in height.
And with the same challenges to be synchronized when you have that height difference. Now, as you can see, balancing and handstands are very important in the sport of sports acrobatics.
Where does sports acrobatics get its name from?
Well, it's really a combination sport. As we mentioned, you'll see a lot of the balance, but then also the throws is what we would call on their tempo routine. But you have to combine both tumbling and dance, and that's a really nice switch leap from Yevgeny. But you have to combine it all together to music, and it's sports acrobatic because it's not theater in a competition sense, but it's very acrobatic, all elements of acrobatics.
They have petitioned to become an Olympic sport. It's not yet been passed, but there's a petition in for sports acrobatics to be an Olympic sport. It also involves men's fours, and it's a sport of its own that involves also power tumbling.
It would seem to have more of a chance just based upon the moves that we're seeing than perhaps the mixed pairs.
Well, as Kurt said, it's an established sport and a great one.
Yevgeny Marchenko and Natasha Redkova, world champion sports acrobats. And here comes a killer, one of the stars of our show, Bart Connor and Killer Joe. Bart really seems to take to this.
Yeah, he's a ham. He's a ham. He always has been. He's always been a great performer, especially on the more exercise. Yeah, he's in a nice position right now, don't you think?
You know, I thought I saw Nadia at the edge of the mat. She won't come out, will she?
We talked about Nadia being in good shape. Bart is in tremendous shape. He's had a lot of operations, had a lot of little problems with his elbows, his shoulder.
He's had 9 operations.
All together.
And yet he still says, for a man who's 37 years old, I can do a pretty good P-bars.
Well, he was Olympic champion on parallel bars. That has to have something to do with it.
Five knee operations. 2 on the biceps and 2 on the elbows.
He's sort of bionic there.
But really what he's done well is change the gymnastics to really transform that into the performance part, which is hard for most gymnasts. I think the choreographer Tony Capella can gymnasts and dancers differently, and he's done a great job in combining that for this performance.
Well, you can certainly see how much Bart loves it and how much that this may become a reality for the future, that these events, certainly we're having a lot of fun here tonight.
Oh, really, this just shows the potential that there is a performance gymnastics, a little bit of lighting, great gymnastics, costume and choreography. It really has just begun.
And if anyone could do it with his personality and his energy, It is Art Connor.
And it gives everybody hope. You can still do gymnastics, 37, 38 years old, right, KT?
Yeah, we're not done yet. Again, you talk about being tired. He had a little rest there sitting on the chair, but he jumped right back into tumbling. That's got to be hard on the knees.
What's the preparation required to do an exhibition like this compared to competition?
Well, I'm sure he had to train quite a bit just to get in shape for this. You know, you're not, when you don't work out every single day in gymnastics, your joints kind of hurt at the end of a workout like this.
He's a killer. Bart Connor as Killer Joe. And when we come back, Bart's fiance, Nadia Comaneci, takes center stage with Sergio Carbajal. That's next on Superstars of Gymnastics.
Backstage between Bart, Nadia, and Vitaly Sherbo.
What's the password?
Password.
You have to have 6 gold medals to go by.
Okay, you got it. You have
okay,
it.
Nadia's got some golds herself, and looking at her, it's hard to believe it's been nearly 20 years since she captivated the world in Montreal.
Oh, well, for me, it's like 50 years ago. But for the, a lot of people that I meet, everybody's telling me, I remember that that was like yesterday. Like, and I'm like, oh no, that was not yesterday. It was long, long time ago. It just makes me very, very old, but I'm very comfortable with that.
And at 33 years old, she looks very comfortable. And now, Nadia with Sergio Carbajal. And this tune is called Always.
As you can see, Sergio is quite a dancer, and he's in really good shape.
This Romeo is bleeding.
It's one thing, it's very difficult to turn on this floor exercise mat because it's got springs under it for tumbling, and dancers find it hard to balance, but Sergio has no problem with any of that.
Also, I would think it grips a little bit as well.
Exactly.
In the flood, see, I've always been on fire, but without you, I give up. I can't sing a love song.
Sergio's actually been taking gymnastics as Nadia comes in for just about 9 months.
Now this is a wonderful routine which you would call adagio work, a little bit different than the sports acrobatic because of the lifts, and it's not hand-to-hand balancing. And I'm sure it's quite a challenge for Nadia because she was an individual gymnast and this is a new technique she has to learn.
This routine is also fairly newly rehearsed by both Nadia and Sergio, and they're carrying it off nicely, very polished.
Well, they're both accomplished performers, Nadia in gymnastics and Sergio in dance, and when you put the two together, this is the effect. Lift. Now you see, this adagio work is one of the choreographic elements that's going to help expand the possibilities for gymnastics performance. It's just one more element of a routine you can create.
Adagio meaning what?
Adagio meaning the partner work that she's doing with the lifts and things with Sergio. Lift there.
The crowd absolutely loving it here at the Spectrum. We wondered about Nadia watching Bart with the dancers, and now I'm wondering about Bart watching Nadia with Sergio.
I think he's peeking out from around the corner. Forget about the drama.
No. Playing it up big tonight.
This is the third variation of the Adagio teamwork that we've seen.
Sergio Carbajal and Nadia Comaneci.
They should both be happy with that performance. It really went off well.
Spectacular. Nicely presented, romantic. And we'll be back with more superstars of gymnastics from Philadelphia in just a moment.
Back at the Spectrum, where the spotlight falls
on Valentin Mogilny. He's going to do a number on the P-bars right now.
And it looks like he's going to play Charlie Chaplin here on the parallel bars. He's been plagued by inconsistency in the past. But parallel bars has been a pretty good event for him.
He really likes the change in costume, doesn't he, Kurt?
Yeah, he does. You notice how he wears sort of free costumes. No shirt on.
The six-time Olympic and world gold medalist.
Beautiful glide straddle to a handstand. Some giant work.
We were talking about a possible comeback for Valentin earlier. Is that possible in your view, Kurt?
Well, he's 29 years of age right now, and I think that his wife keeps coaching him hard enough, I think he'll be all right. There's a double back. Now, I don't think he's finished. Just one moment. He's going to jump back on. He's done that twice now. Now, normally you're not allowed to do a dismount and jump back on, obviously, but...
So in competition, you dismount, you're done.
You're done. You don't want to move after that dismount.
He's definitely done now. Up next, Dominic Moceanu, the 13-year-old ball of fire from Houston.
Innovative start there. You know, she's very young, but she's very mature in her performance and very confident. Here's her series. Whoa. Oh, just a little bit off there.
She's performing to Ray Charles and Georgia, perhaps a reference next summer. You don't want to do that in Georgia next summer.
No, not next summer. She can do it in a show, though. Looks like she's going to try it again, which you can't do in competition, but she wants to make sure and get it right for the show, which she did.
Nice.
That's an advantage to a show like this, don't you think?
Yeah, shows are great for young gymnasts to get them out performing and to get their confidence level up in front of a big audience. Punch front, very solid.
Dominique says her heroes are Svetlana Boginskaya and Kim Zemeskal, with whom she trains.
Yeah, that's got to be a great advantage to train with your idols in the same gym, and very inspiring.
Years old, you got to figure Dominique's going to be around for quite some time.
Yeah, I think she has yet to hit her peak. She's saving it for the future. As you can see, little bobbles, and that's a little bit of inexperience, but I think she has a very good mental state, which means that she can get on a beam and concentrate well, and that's going to make the difference. punch, double back, for a dismount.
Dominique Moceanu. Another look at her back lift off the beam.
Well, here's her acro series. She starts with a back handspring, and then she's so small, she can fit three layout backouts on the beam.
What's normal for the beam?
Usually about two layouts. It's about 16 foot long, but she's a tiny tyke, and she fit it all in.
And once again, for some serious gymnastics, Paul Hunt.
Well, with an outfit like that, you know it's going to be serious.
Said earlier that he developed this routine while teaching some of his younger gymnasts?
Well, he didn't develop the routine. He jumped up on the beam one time to show one of his girls how to do, I guess, a backflip the right way, and found out that it was kind of funny because here's a man jumping up on the balance beam doing a backflip, and he just worked with it from there. And I tell you, to this day, he is the best gymnastics clown. Nobody performs like Paul Hunt.
So he did not start with the dress.
No, the dress came later. Imagine packing for work and putting your leotards in your bag.
Although Paul seems to like it. We know his audience, his fans do.
This is really tough to do. Back handsprings in a circle like that. You have to lean. Talk about the wrong technique on a skill.
Story behind it. This swan lake was used by Kathy Johnson, who is one of the great American gymnasts and an award winner in floor. And Paul does a lot of her movements, but he actually adds his own special touch.
I've seen this routine hundreds of times, and I'm smiling right now watching him.
That's got to be tough to stay up on your toes like that. He runs Hunt's Gymnastics in Salt Lake City, and as we mentioned earlier, competed during the early 70s. Big Ten Florex champ, and the 1972 National Florex champion.
Here comes a nice danger pass. Back layout to your stomach.
Ooh! What do you call that move, Kurt?
That's a Paulina Hunt-askew.
Paul Hunt delighting the crowd here at the Spectrum. Pauletta Hunt-askew, his performing name, we'll say. And another look at some of his handsprings.
Look how he has to lean in just to make it into a circle. That's not easy.
Up now is perennial fan favorite, Kim Zumeskal. She hails from Houston, Texas, a four-time U.S. national champion. She retired after Barcelona, but after a while, she found she missed the sport more than she thought.
I didn't even think I'd want to do gymnastics after the Olympics. I was thinking, well, I'll do the, you know, 9 or so exhibitions that we have to do afterwards, and I'm going to go back to school, finish high school, go to college, you know. Just like that, it took me about 3 or 4 months, and I was like, I missed gymnastics. And so I came back, and then now to have Svetlana here, I would never have dreamed that would have happened, but it's been really good for both of us. I mean, we're going through essentially the same things, having to come back after not training after a long period of time, and it's just something that I've always kind of dreamed of happening, and, you know, being able to be friends with her, you know, in an everyday situation. It's been good.
Kim and Svetlana Boganskaya trained together with Bella Caroli in Houston and have been doing so for about a year.
the most popular American Olympian in Barcelona. She received the most fan mail.
And you know, Mike, talking about training with Svetlana, they were supposed to be fierce rivals, especially by the press, from 91 through 92, so it's pretty incredible that they've become friends and training partners. Is there a signature handstand move?
You talk about her comeback with Bella Caroli. He says, if anyone can do it, Kimbo can do it.
Well, Kimbo, unfortunately, did not have the game she wanted in 92. She got a bronze in the team, but was one of the favorites on the beam. And you can take it from there, Wendy. What happened?
Well, what happened is during the compulsory exercises, which is one of the first exercises you have to do, she had a fall on beam. And when you fall, that's a 5/10 deduction. So if you're in the top, it just takes right out of contention. So that was really heartbreaking. But she did come back to help the team win the bronze medal. So it wasn't all bad.
She also apparently had some shin splints or a stress fracture at Barcelona, and because of that, watered down her routines, and perhaps that cost her as well in some of her other events.
Well, I think it was the fall that broke her concentration, but you can see now she still has a love for gymnastics, and she's very, very solid and confident on the beam. A lot of really difficult elements, and it's not easy to come back, but she's really giving it her all. Oh, there's a layout. Can you hold on?
Coming off knee surgery, I would think it would be very gratifying if she could make the Olympic team next summer.
Oh, definitely. It's got to be quite a challenging event, but as a former world champion, I'm sure she can do it. So dismount, double back summit. Very nice.
Kim Zemeskal, 19 years old, from Houston, Texas. And we'll take another look at her dismount, as she is clearly the fan favorite here in Philadelphia.
Here she's preparing. You do a round off on the beam, and then you punch it up and rotate twice, grabbing those knees in. Look for the ground and a nice landing.
Much more from Philadelphia when we return. Svetlana Boginskaya comes flipping your way, as well as Bart and Nadia, and more from the superstars of gymnastics from the Spectrum in just a moment. Here she is, the Belarusian swan, Svetlana Boginskaya, with a little hip hop on the floor.
I tell you, Michael, Svetlana owns floor exercise. She is so captivating on this event.
She lists it as her favorite, along with the beam.
Svetlana walk.
If she has difficulty in her comeback, it'll be here on the floor exercise. Her tumbling is not really at the Olympic level yet. Although there's a nice double 2.5 punch front.
Looks
That's
close.
Really nice.
Looks close to me.
That's a new element for her.
She was a figure skater at one point, but quit the sport, felt it was too cold. And appropriately, this routine is to the tune of Summertime.
Very nice front tumbling series.
Years old, 5 feet, 3¾ inches, 105 pounds, began gymnastics at age 6.
Nice double back for a dismount. You know, Svetlana's smile has really made a difference. It just helps her sell the routine that much more.
Svetlana Boginskaya with a little hip hop to Summertime. And she's living very easy tonight. A nice routine. Here's another look.
Here she's setting up for her dismount. She's really got to get a lot of power. Go for a round off into the back handspring, and then it's just about power and timing, punching it up for the double back.
Once again, Lavinia Corina Milosevic. Milos. Woo. She starts it off with a nice move.
Full in, back out. I mean, you can just see, as I said, the quality of her gymnastics is so complete. Every move is finished and extremely difficult.
This is her favorite event.
One of the most difficult routines in the world on the floor exercise. Watch this pass. Round off, whip, whip, whip. Back handspring. Double full punch front.
But remember, in women's floor exercise, besides all the hard tumbling, you have to show dance, balance elements, flexibility, and grace.
Now, she's won a world or Olympic title in every event, as we told you before, but no overall title. How does that happen?
Well, it's just when you really hit all around. When they mean all around, that means you're the best on all four events combined, and maybe she's just had some mishaps, but maybe she's just waiting for her time. Ooh, last pass, triple twist.
Milos, Lavinia Milosevic.
Now here's that second tumbling pass. Does three whip backs, then she goes into the back handspring then. And this is so complicated. Here she has a double twist in laid out position. She's spying the floor, not even finishing, and then she punches right through to a front summy. A lot of tricks in that pass.
You have to consider her a favorite for next summer. Continuing on the floor, the James Dean of gymnastics. Rebel with a cause, or without a cause, we're not sure. Vitaly Sherbo.
Rebel with 6 gold medals.
You got that right.
Well, he normally mounts with a double twisting, double layout. Let's see what he tries here. Once again, he's been plagued with a little bit of a problem with his wrist. Oh, there's a nice high double layout. Easily could have fit 2 twists in.
He had 2 shoulder surgeries last summer. Preferred to have them done in Minsk.
He's just cleaning things up a little bit. A little scrape here, a little scrape there. He's fixing himself up for 96.
Vitaly says, I thought I was the best in the world then, not now. Do you agree with that?
He was the best then. He'll be the best in 96, in my opinion. Again, he had the injuries. He's working through them. If he can train without getting injured and keep his body healthy, I don't think there's anyone that's going to beat him.
He doesn't train a lot, does he?
Not right now. I think he's kind of saving himself. He knows what he needs.
Six gold medals in the 92 games, Vitaly Sherbo. And coming up, Nadia and Bart in a romantic duet. Also, Philippe Chartrand flies from above. That's when Superstars of Gymnastics returns. Thomas back at the Spectrum with the Superstars of Gymnastics. And Wendy, this has been billed as the past, present, and future of the sport. What's coming up?
Well, the next is a theme is going to be from outer space. And so all the routines will have kind of a futuristic feel. And it's a lot of fun for the gymnasts. They can really express themselves and do some of the moves that are just from out of this world.
All right, Kurt, got a guy by the name of Philippe Chartrand. Tell us a bit about him.
He's a former national Canadian champion, and he's going to be performing a very special event. I don't want to give it away, but he's from the critically acclaimed Cirque du Soleil performing group. Stay tuned.
All right, out in space, coming up.
Good evening. This is the voice.
And now on the parallel bars, Valerie Liukin. This is quite a routine, Kurt.
Yep, here's where you'll see the trickster at work. Now, anytime a gymnast tells you, you know, the lights were in his eyes or whatever, just have him watch this guy. He's got a mask on. Look at the outfit he's wearing.
Just did some beautiful flares on the end, right into some giant work.
How'd you invent the flare?
Well, it just sort of happened in workout one day. I was swinging around on pommel horse and splitting my legs, and the next thing you know, I was competing with it. A Healy twirl. Fell out of that. You can't even tell he made a mistake there. Big stuff to a handstand. And his dismount. Tuck double back.
Valerie Liukin. Meanwhile, backstage, Nadia Comaneci and Bart Connor preparing for their duet. You'll see that in a moment. The two of them engaged to be married, and they come from such different backgrounds, you wonder how it's a match. And Bart talked to us about Nadia's adjustment to living in the United States.
You know, we grow up in America where we basically want to think that the next person right there has good intentions. Well, she grew up in a society where they don't believe that way. So if someone walked up to her and said, hey, how are you doing, and wanted to talk with her, her reaction is, what do you want from me? Because that's where she grows up. That's how they are. And I tend to be more outgoing. And I had to help her understand that she needed to trust people. People were basically okay, but she had been taken advantage of so many times that her underlying belief about people was that people were not okay. And that, to me, was a tragedy. This wonderful individual who gave the world so many wonderful things was not happy because she didn't have the right environment. She didn't trust people. She was very insecure with, you know, any strangers, people coming in from the outside. And so I tried to help her understand that trust people. They'll do the right thing if you give them a chance. And I think that she understands that, and in most cases, I think she applies that.
And now on the floor, Bart and Nadia.
Somewhere out there, if love can see all.
Somewhere out there, Bart Conner and Nadia Comaneci. I think that pretty much sums everything up. You don't need to say anything else. And in a little less than a year, they will be husband and wife. Now we switch gears. There's a phantom in the house.
Talk about distractions. Look at this outfit. He's got a mask on, and he's going to work the horizontal bar. This should be interesting.
Let's see how that cape works with those giant slings.
What a great effect, though. Look at that. Beautiful staller work. In-bar work. That swing. His shoulders are very extended. One-arm giants. Dismount, a double back with a full twist, half and half out.
Valentin Mogilny.
I don't think he's done, Michael.
Little encore here. I'll tell you what, the gymnasts have gone all out with regard to costume and lighting.
Let's not talk about thinking about the music.
Absolutely. I think that about does it for Valentin. Valentin Mogilny. And now a very special treat. Kurt talked about it a little while ago. Philippe Chartrand. What do we call this? The flying rig?
Well, kind of flying straps, as Kurt mentioned. He's from Cirque du Soleil. And a lot of gymnasts are going to Cirque du Soleil to become performers. But now that we have this form, maybe many of them will stay in performance gymnastics.
Cirque du Soleil is the traveling gymnastics circus troupe that now has a permanent home in Las Vegas, but they go around the country and around the world showcasing gymnastics and music and all sorts of theatrics. And Philippe Chartrand makes his home in Las Vegas, where there is a permanent setup for Cirque du Soleil.
Started in Canada. And by the way, Philippe is a two-time Canadian Olympic team member.
Now, you know, someone's got to be working the straps. And for Philippe, it's his wife, Cecile. So we hope there are no arguments before they come to the arena.
Talk about trusting your partner.
Yes.
Tremendous amount of upper body strength required for this.
But also it's the overall package, it's the makeup and the costume or lack thereof, but that really makes it an exciting theater piece. Very effective.
Can you compare this to another event?
You'd have to compare it to the still rings, if anything, because of the way the straps are wrapped around the arms. And he goes through a cross position, an iron cross position. There's a front lever that we usually do on the rings in a straddle position. There, it's front lever.
He designed the flying system he currently uses. And in fact, before the performance, we watched him test it wanted to make sure everything was just right.
Another demonstration of potential that gymnastics has for a theater presentation. You don't always have to use the traditional apparatus. You can have some very innovative pieces using something like Philippe is using here, the straps.
I would think the coordination needed to use your feet in the straps as opposed to your hands looks exceedingly difficult.
It really is where you distribute your weight, and special technique that Philippe has really mastered at this point.
A physique that looks as if it could have been sculpted by Auguste Rodin.
Mesmerizing,
yeah.
The effect of this work, and you have to notice when he does land, he always does it so softly, so much control, which is really the basis behind gymnastics.
Well, we've got to give some credit to Cecile, I think, for that.
Oh, definitely. Good teamwork.
The magic and mystique of Philippe Chartrand, as Wendy said, mesmerizing. And we'll be back with more from the superstars of gymnastics from Philadelphia in just a moment. Chartrand receiving congratulations after his breathtaking performance. But right now, the crowd has called for an encore from Kim Zemestel. A four-time national champion, ready for an encore performance on the Florex. Mm-hmm.
Kim is a powerful tumbler. She starts off with a double layout. Excellent.
Would that mat be there in competition?
No, it wouldn't. It's really just to give you a little extra protection and make the landing just a little bit softer for training.
Remember, she just came off that knee surgery, so I'm sure she needs a little protection there.
As we told you earlier, the most popular American Olympian in Barcelona, easily the crowd favorite here in Philadelphia tonight.
The famous whip pass to a double back.
Is this Olympic form here? Is this medal form?
Not yet. I think it's really the start of her Olympic routine and her Olympic comeback, really getting back out there doing gymnastics in front of the crowd. But, you know, Kim's got great tumbling passes, so I have no doubt that it'll be right up there for Olympic form next year.
Yeah, she'll beef these passes up a lot. She'll twist probably the first trick, the double layout, and possibly twist the pass after the double back after the whip backs.
Currently training with legendary coach Bella Caroli in Houston, Texas. Kim Semesko with an encore performance here at the Spectrum.
Now it's really great to see Kim back again. It's really tough for a gymnast to get back in the Olympic form.
And she looks like she's close. We'll have a final word from Philadelphia when we come back. You can Philadelphia for a curtain call as the performers say goodnight. And it's been a fun night. Wendy, Kurt, your final thoughts?
Well, what's wonderful about this event is the combination of all the elements. You have the dance, the theater, the lights, and of course the gymnastics, which makes it an exciting event to look forward to in the future.
I thought it was great. The gymnasts had a lot of fun. We had a lot of fun. And it gives you an idea of what's ahead for the future of gymnastics.
Well, it sure has been a great time, and it's been a pleasure for USA Network to present this one-of-a-kind event for Kurt Thomas and Wendy Hilliard. I'm Michael Barkan. Good night, everyone, from Philadelphia.